Science changes the world every day, but we rarely think deeply about the environmental impact of doing that research. Laboratories consume up to 10 times more energy than a typical commercial office. They consume 4 times more water than a typical commercial office. The pharmaceutical industry globally produces 55% higher emissions than the automotive industry. And laboratories produce 12 billion pounds of plastic waste each year. While ambitious carbon commitments are great, they need to be backed up by action. And this is really where My Green Lab comes in. We provide the tools and the frameworks and the verification that companies are truly taking action to address their overall climate goals.
Scientists in scientific labs around the world face a unique dilemma. On the one hand, they're working to understand the causes and the impacts of climate change. On the other hand, they're actually one of the contributors towards it. So they're quite rightly making demands of companies like us to produce technologies and solutions that help them avoid some of those challenges. Thermo Fisher Scientific has around 80,000 colleagues spread around the world, enabling our customers to deal with some of the most complex problems that face society.
Thermo Fisher is a strategic partner for My Green Lab. They've been one of the early adopters of our tools in terms of improving the sustainability of their products through the ACT label, as well as supporting our Freezer Challenge program, which is working to drive efficiency and very high energy consuming equipment, ultra-low temperature freezers.
I think there is a growing awareness that the science alone is not going to save us, that we as individuals need to take an active role in bringing sustainability into our everyday. Yet bringing sustainability into the laboratory environment can be challenging. For many scientists, I think there is a very common conception that incorporating sustainability into their work is going to come at the cost of their science, that they're going to have to sacrifice time, quality, or even success in order to make their work sustainable. And a big part of what we do at My Green Lab is helping scientists identify the ways that they can incorporate sustainability into their daily work without compromising the integrity of their science. Because after all, if science doesn't work anymore, it's not a sustainable solution.
My Green Labs has helped Thermo Fisher Scientific address our sustainability goals by shining a spotlight on the problem, by challenging us to do our part, and then by creating specific initiatives, for example, the freezer competition program, where we can actually support our customers to do their part as well.
When you look at where energy is consumed in a laboratory, about 20% of the energy is related to plug load, or really all of that equipment that is plugged into the wall. And laboratory freezers and refrigerators make up a large portion of the plug load. The International Freezer Challenge is an annual competition that encourages laboratories to adopt best practices that can help to reduce the energy consumption of cold storage. When you want to engage people in sustainability, it's important to make it fun. And competitions and challenges are a fun and exciting way to get people to take action on a topic that they otherwise might not have taken action on. And they also allow you to very easily reward people for taking the sustainable actions that you want to encourage.
One of the specific programs that I'm most proud of at Thermo Fisher Scientific is the innovation that we put into the market as the first provider in the life sciences to have a fully recyclable paper cooler. Every year, millions of cubic feet of polystyrene are put into landfill as customers rely on these to transport products backwards and forwards or store products in a cold environment.
Being able to compare products based on their environmental attributes is something that we have all become accustomed to doing in our daily lives. We can compare paper based on how much recycled content it has or whether the pulp was sustainably sourced. We can compare apples on whether they were organically grown or not. When it comes to laboratory products, we haven't had the same convenience and the same way of being able to compare two similar products based on their environmental attributes. And this is part of why we introduced the ACT label, so that we could bring accountability, consistency, and transparency into how people were looking at and comparing laboratory products.
The ACT label is like a eco-nutrition label for products. And the way that it acts is that that product actually gets scored on different aspects of the product. One is the manufacturing of the product, the other is the user impact of that product, and then the third is the end of life. And all of those scores combined come into what's called the environmental impact factor score. The lower the score, the more environmentally friendly that product is.
I think it's important to realize that we're all in this together. We actually need radical collaboration across the industry if we're going to create the breakthroughs that are truly going to transform science.
When a company has this reach and the resources that Thermo Fisher has, they can really set the expectation for what sustainable products in the laboratory look like and help to inspire the industry to move towards a more sustainable future.
Imagine if every scientist was fluent in sustainability and knew how to make a difference through their work and their actions. Imagine if every lab was green and every product was designed with the environment in mind. Imagine if there was a thriving culture of sustainability in every leading institution in science. That's our vision for the next decade, and we firmly believe that science can be a global leader on environmental sustainability.